Hey everybody, Alan Darko here, and I am back again. And yeah, more RE2. So it's about midnight here, and I would have liked to have done this earlier, but you know, things came up. I was busy hanging out with some friends, playing some Smash Bros. If you go check out Zen's channel, you'll see a little bit of what we did. So here's hoping you do that. That being said, yeah, no, I got everything here. Just making sure, because it never hurts to do so. All right, moving on. You know, I actually don't know if zombies respawn in this game. I'm gonna assume they don't, but you know what they say about assumptions? Don't make them, because you will often be wrong. That's how the saying goes, right? I'm pretty sure it's right. 9%. Alright. Oh, right! Major apologies to everybody who had to watch that last video without any in-game audio. Hopefully the non-licensed music I chose was satisfactory. The knob turns, but the door won't budge. It seems to be sealed from the other side. Oh, right, this little puzzle. Something is written on the mountain. The god of sun and the god of moon. Their gaze upon me is the only thing that can release Red's soul. Alright, so it's pretty clear what you gotta do here, right? You see these two statues? Yeah, you see those two, I guess, indents? Or, I don't even know how I'd begin to describe it, but the two parts of the floor that are clearly different. Well, I hope this is clear to you all, because if not... that's really it. What isn't clear is how I actually push these things. Alright, there we go. But yeah, you just gotta push them into these, like, slots? Whatever you want to call them. And then that bruff there is gonna drop that jewel. I don't remember every puzzle in this game, but some of the easier ones, I guess like this, are pretty hard to forget. Not like you couldn't figure them out in about a second if you just took a, you know, if you looked. And I will reiterate, who designed this police station? It's a fucking madhouse! Spade keys, club keys, red jewels. What is this? Oh, not to mention that one of them was hidden in a painting I had to burn, and the other one I had to solve a very rudimentary puzzle with. It's just... it doesn't make any logical sense, and ladies and gentlemen, I know this is a video game, but... come on. Come on. Alright. I hear the shuffles. Now, you can call me a bitch for just standing here waiting them to come, but... tired of running forward into the next screen to get an attack. I think they're eating. You see? See what happens when you're not cautious? Wasting way too many fucking bullets, and I'm not happy about it. Alright. Son of a bitch. That happened. Oh, I think this is where I get the shotgun, maybe. Don't quote me on that. Nice. So y'all remember that licker who was wrecking my shit? Yeah. We'll see what's what in a bit. Normally I'd be overjoyed, but now I'm out of inventory space. There's a picture of a man. There's a good chance it's her boyfriend. I guess she plays the guitar too. That's pretty sexy. Chris's diary. August 8th. I talked to the chief today. Once again, sorry. I'm actually looking for something. Alrighty. And it is found. My bad for that weird delay. I talked to the chief today once again, but he refused to listen to me. I know for certain that Umbrella conducted T-virus research in that mansion. Anyone infected turns into a zombie. But that entire mansion went up in that explosion, along with any incriminating evidence. Since Umbrella employs so many people in town, no one is willing to talk about the incident. It looks like I'm running out of options. August 17th. We've been receiving a lot of local reports about strange monsters appearing at random throughout the city. This must be the work of Umbrella. August 24th. With the help of Jill and Barry, I finally obtained information vital to this case. Umbrella has begun research on the new G-Virus, a variation of the original T-Virus. Haven't they done enough damage already? We talked it over and have decided to fly to the main Umbrella headquarters in Europe. I won't tell my sister about this trip because doing so could put her in danger. Please forgive me, Claire. Aw, shit. And that is fantastic.
Leon!
It's good to see you're still among the living. It looks like we're not gonna find your brother here after all. There's no reason for us to stay any longer than necessary. Let's split up, look for any survivors, and get out of here.
Right.
One last thing. Here's a radio. Take it. That way we can keep in touch if anything happens.
I can't believe what is happening to this city.
Yeah. It's pretty fucking wild, ain't it? You know, away she goes. There's various trophies. One of them reads, Marksman Contest, Chris Redfield. Alright, well, I'm gonna come back for that medallion. I'm hoping not to waste any of my items, so I'm not gonna take any of these health things unless I gotta. So, I'm running back to my storage box like a coward, and I will be back. No. You know, I was actually gonna defend the dialogue in this game, but I think I'm gonna abstain from doing that because I've realized how fucking mad it is. What I will say is, it is a step up from the first game. That it most certainly is. What else can I say during this backtracking? Oh, right. Leon got way cooler in the years that's happened between this one and 4. He got a sweeter haircut and a sweeter jacket. Alright, all I got in there is my shotgun shells. Shotgun's gonna go in there. I'm gonna stash my ink ribbons. That one might not be such a hot idea. I don't know where the red jewels go. I wish I had a weaker herb, but I've mixed them, and what's done is done. However, there is a weak herb by where that fucking liquor is. I'm gonna finish exploring this area up here. I'm gonna grab that shoddy. I'm gonna go wreck his shit. I should probably save before I attempt to go wreck his shit. You know what? I'll be fine. I'm on high caution, and I have 2 healing items. That isn't to say things can't go wrong, but it's unlikely. It's unlikely. I actually don't remember where that medallion goes. Is that something back there? Nah, it's just a can. Thought that might have been handgun bullets. I know it's a Star's office. I would like you to go in, Leon. Please and thank you. Alright. I guess Claire's still here. It's trashed. Someone must have searched the desk. Searched the desk, huh? Oh, it looks like I can't. Nothing suspicious, nor out of the ordinary. It appears to be a replica of a gun. The owner's probably a member of the NRA. But you're making some vast assumptions there, Leon. That's not even a rifle. Alright. I don't think there's anything else in here. I mean, I already got a shotgun out of the closet, so maybe I'm just being greedy. Yeah, so we'll take the unicorn medal.
I can't believe what is happening to this city.
Oh, someone's a broken record. Alright. Sorry about that, folks. I'm just a tad bit sleepy. Moving on. Jeez. I feel like I'm gonna regret my choice to keep going. It's locked. A spade is actually under the keyhole. Small ventilation shaft. It's far too small for an adult to fit into. Hint, hint, clue. Alright. Looks like I'm headed back. Alright, folks. Round two. No holds barred. Me versus that liquor. Let's see who licks who. No, I've actually been thinking about what, I guess, the optimal loadout is. Like, I don't want to get rid of my handgun, because then what am I going to do with zombies with? I don't want to be wasting valuable ammo on things that, well, don't call for it. That's madness. Alright, I'm going to put my first aid spray away. I'm going to actually throw the knife away. Put that back. I'm gonna put the unicorn medallion back, and I'm taking my shells. I don't predict I'm actually gonna need all 5 bullets to kill the liquor, but hey, shit happens, right? Alright, there's this room, I think this door was locked. Yep, a diamond is etched under the keyhole, of course. I am not looking forward to this encounter. It's alright. I have the means now. Gotta stay away. I fucking called it. What did I tell you guys? Gotta stay away from those windows. Oh god, that was a little scary. Probably doesn't hurt to move a little slowly through this hallway just so you don't accidentally run nearer to the window than you intend to. Alright guys, do this. 1v1 no camp kills. I'll fuck you up. Punk ass trick. Alright. Let's reload. Fantastic. Grab that herb you cock-blocked me out of. Even better. Let's use the herb as not to make use of our better healing items at the moment. Glorious. Get that pistol out so as not to... Well... Not to shoot at anything I don't need to with it. Fucking lord over his corpse for about a second. And it's locked. A spade is etched under the keyhole. Alright, folks, I'm honestly at a loss as to what to do. You know what the upside is? I'm honestly at a loss for time. It's an open close switch with the shutter, it can't be activated, cord's cut. And I'm torn between making this video a little bit longer and, well, calling it here. I guess I'll... I know where I haven't gone. I feel like such a fucking waste to do this. But I can't think of another alternative. Welcome back to Alan Darko, can't fucking prioritize objectives and is gonna end up wasting shells where he probably doesn't need to. But if I don't waste shells here, I am gonna be out of handgun bullets, like, completely. And I also just wasted a nerve on my health right now, so... I guess I'm doing what I feel I gotta do. Alright. Steady. Steady. Hold. Hold. Steady. Steady. Hold. Oh shit, I forgot about that. Ain't that some shit? Steady. I wasted one more shell than I would have liked to, but I really don't want to be wasting health either. You know, I think you can kind of tell if they're dead by the way they moan too, but don't quote me on that. Zombies are crafty sons of bitches. And awesome, more herbage. Alright folks, and once again, if I'm out of herbs, I seem to be out of ammo. If I'm out of ammo, I seem to be out of herbs. I have very few bullets left. But, we have another route open to us now. And let's see what's what. Any items? Nope. Here's hoping this fucking room isn't loaded with zombies. Oh, who am I kidding? They always are. What? Already? Dios mios. Why? Are you kidding me? At least you saved me some bullets. Alright. See? You get rid of the- I get rid of my knife, and what happens? Gotta waste a shell on this basic son of a bitch here. That was not a good trade. There was absolutely nothing- a diamond is etched under the keyhole. Nothing good about what I just did. I forgot what red herbs do. I think when mixed with singular green herbs, they enhance the potency. But once again, do not quote me on that. Okay, I can enter this room. I was hoping it's not a fucking death trap. I think I remember this room. Come on, Leon. You can maneuver a little better than that. Yes, I will take that small key. Thank you. Nothing special on the shelf. Nothing over here. Oh. Right. Awesome. I'm not gonna spoil what I remember happening here, but I guess I had the wrong room. And there's still one door left, but I'm pretty sure I remember this one being locked. Club is etched into the keyhole. Let's see. Can we examine items in this game? Check. I can open a simple lock with this. I actually only have one simple lock that I remember at the moment. And I guess that's where I'm headed. It's always moments like this where I find... I know where the unicorn medallion goes. Alright guys, that is the last thing I'm doing this episode. It's already gonna run on a bit long, but that's okay, because you know what? We're getting somewhere. My memory isn't as faulty as I remember it. My memory isn't as faulty as I remember it being. That's one hell of a sentence right there. But I literally have no bullets. I have 3 shells left. And I'm not too keen on wasting them. What? I think... Alright. Check it. I'm pretty sure you can use the key here, and it gives you an upgrade for your handgun. But I am also fairly certain that back in the storage room, or the photo room, whatever, where I last saved the game, those 2 locks that are, well, locked. I am fairly positive I can still... that I can use that small key there as well. So here goes something. Huh, I guess I don't do it every time. I wonder if I didn't get close enough, or if they only do it, like, every other time, or some other odd iteration like that. Anyways, let's check this shit out. I don't know what I'll find in there, but I'm just hoping it's great. And if those lockers don't open with that key, well, I'll just... get it on the way back. Oh, a special kind of key. Never mind. I guess the key I got wasn't special enough. Alright. I'm gonna do something daring. Alright. Let's go. Now, I don't know how everybody feels about the, I guess, extra length these videos are going to typically be. But the way I figure it, if I'm going to get these games done in the remaining days I have to Halloween, I'm either going to have extra long videos, or I'm going to have to record long sessions, cut them into 3 videos, and upload several in one day. I'm probably going to end up going with the latter after today if I can help it. It'll be a little more time consuming, but I think it'll be worth it just for, the way I figure it, having them in one long chunk, I don't think it's that big a deal, but yeah, it's hard to imagine someone sitting here for 40 minutes and watching this. Let's say I record for an hour, I cut it into 3 videos. If you want to keep going and keep watching, by all means, I'd love for anyone who would want to do so. But for those who are either strapped for time or just are sane human beings who don't want to watch 40-minute bursts of one game at a time, then it'll be easier for them as well. But, so I guess this video and the next video silent... Oh. Well, you know what? I was bitching about a lack of ammo and... I guess either way, it was worth. I'm just gonna try to avoid using bullets as much as I can. But yeah, I believe this and the next Silent Hill are gonna be the last jumbo-sized videos. And after that, well, get ready for saturation of several in one day. Oh, right, I guess I should have An old fountain. Something is written here. To obtain the key to open your heart, I'll wait for the unicorn, the beautiful beast. So there we go. Use. And I'm pretty sure we get the heart key from this. Will you take the precinct key? Yes. Alright. Well guys, that's gonna do it for me here. All I'm gonna do is run back to the photo room, save, and you're not gonna be missing anything if I don't record that. Anyways, as always, been Alan Darko. Thank you for watching, and next time, we have keys to work with. Catch you guys later.